just hold that up.
Yeah.
And when everyone in the room is ready, come on. Well, 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 Mathilde Gremaud, it's so good to see you. Look at those beautiful medals.
Yeah, they're pretty cool.
Guys, this is a very special day. Thank you for joining us on Olympic Winter Games Daily. We have a free ski superstar in the vicinity. I feel so privileged to have you here. I mean, how has this Olympics gone for you? How can you describe it?
Well, it was pretty intense. It was really, really nice, and I had a lot of fun. We started with big air, and I really, really wanted a medal. And I was super, super happy and relieved after it happened. And then it was like, from that moment, it was like a big emotion roller coaster. And it was really hard in the slopestyle training and everything, but it turned out really amazing. So just had the best time.
And what a ride. I mean, it's been wild and beautiful to watch. For you emotionally, it must have been quite challenging.
Yeah, it was really challenging. I felt quite empty after the big air, because it was like such a reward, and I hadn't have like the best season, like starting of the season. So I was like, whoa, at least I have this, and like, yeah. I can really be happy about that. And then, yeah, we started skiing the slopestyle, and it was I didn't really enjoy it. I couldn't find like really the motivation and until the last day. So yeah.
I mean, I want to dive into this with you a bit more, but before we do, I want to spark your competitive spirit. Okay, so who is the most is kind of the idea. Who is the most skillful?
Freestyle skiers.
Who parties the hardest?
I haven't really been partying with the snowboarders, but I mean, it's really fun with the skiers, but I would almost go with snowboarders.
Most competitive?
Skiers.
Trains the hardest?
Skiers. Skiers, I would say. I don't know.
Best style?
Snowboarders.
Really?
Yeah.
Funniest?
It depends. I just know most of the snowboarder girls, but like not really the guys. So I will go with skiers.
What is it like to turn up at an Olympics with so much, I guess, pressure and expectation, and for yourself coming into an Olympics as a silver medalist already?
I think for me it was like almost a relief. I was like, yeah, whatever happens, I already have my silver medal from 4 years ago, and like I can just enjoy and have a good time. And for me, like, I had no pressure at all.
That sounds like you're making it sound easy, but I can imagine it wasn't.
It definitely wasn't for some time in the summer, and like maybe through the last season also with everything happening with COVID. I think it was I could feel the tension like kind of building towards the Olympics, and having like kind of a weird vibe every now and then. And yeah, it was not easy, but then in the end, when I look back, I just feel like it was I did have to like do some kind of work on myself, but it was worth it. And also it was interesting because I feel like I learned some new tips or new tricks for myself and how to go about things.
It's interesting hearing you talk about it, because clearly it was a big process for you, but it worked. Look at you now.
Yeah, I think it worked. And I for some things, I have like answers about like why it worked. Mm-hmm. And for still a huge part of it, I don't have the answer. And it's like, I just feel lucky that I was able to not overthink too much about certain stuff. So that was like, yeah, I'm thankful for my brain for not going too crazy.
Let's talk about this roller coaster, because in slopestyle, you know, you had to go from big air where you'd been incredibly successful, and then all of a sudden you had to kind of shift your mindset and focus on another event. I mean, talk me through that roller coaster. It is wild.
How, like I said earlier, I felt really empty after big air. And then we started skiing slopestyle. And actually, like, right after Big Air, I was so soaked and super motivated for slopestyle. And I was like, I can't wait to, like, spend more time on snow because Big Air is, like, really quick, sort of, like, one jump and done. And, like, it's intense. And then it's over. But slopestyle is more, like, fluid. And, like, you can just go through the whole run. And it's a lot of skiing. And I was really looking forward to that. And then came to training, first training. I was just exhausted. And yeah, the day of qualification, I was like, okay, I have to just make it, and it's gonna be two more days, and then I can fully relax, and I can, like,
breathe.
I can breathe, exactly. I had, like, a weird run, and, like, I scared myself on the second jump, and then I was like, I don't think I can do it. And then I got on the chairlift, and my coach was like, are you okay? Like, I know that it's hard. We haven't said anything. And that's, like, when I started crying. And I cried for, like, 30 minutes. And I had, yeah, I just practically, like, missed half of the training. During my first run of quali, I was just really not sure I could do it. So I literally did the most stupid run ever. I did my rail run and then do three same trick on the jumps, and then I was like, okay, I have another chance. I'm gonna try to do it, take it. And yeah, I got pretty lucky on that qualification day that I still made it. And then yeah, the final day, the first run was actually pretty good that I crashed because it distracted me. I had to go back up, fix my ski, make my new ski ready, take the edges off a little bit.
What actually happened? You broke a binding or something?
Yeah, my stopper kind of, like, it didn't break. I think it's like you could fix it, but it's just like a piece got out and then it was loose and it was not working anymore. So I just took another ski, and like that took some time, and I didn't have time to think about the fact that I crashed.
Perfect start to an Olympic final, really, right? I mean, come on.
Yeah, I mean, I was standing at the top at the second run, and I was almost laughing. I was like, why did it happen? But it's okay. I have two more runs.
Then there's the waiting game. There's this amazing thing where you guys, after you kind of are sitting first, second, and third, you sit and wait at the bottom. And you were there, you were waiting, and then here comes Eileen, this 18-year-old from China who has just been trying to mess up everyone's hopes and dreams a little bit, and she stomps this incredible run, and 0.33 is behind you. Talk me through, like, I guess, like, standing there waiting for all of that to unfold.
Yeah, I mean, it was cool to stand there and, like, see actually everyone else. Since I dropped first into the last run, I had, like, 11 girls to watch and, like, wait for their scores. And, yeah, it's, like, nerve-wracking, but at the same time, I was like, it's a beautiful day. Everyone is hopefully having fun, and I was, like, kind of rooting for everyone. It was pretty fun. Like, I felt like I was like, oh, this is cool. I can watch.
You had the best seat in the house, right?
Exactly. Exactly. And yeah, that was pretty cool. But then obviously, like, if I saw a little mistake, I was like, okay, like, I think that's gonna be okay for me this time, this run as well. And I was like just working my way through the last run like that, just kind of like fingers crossed. Yeah, Eileen came down and I was like, well, that was a pretty perfect run. But I had a little bit of hope with my first jump trick that I think was not expected from the judges or anyone else. So I was just hoping that literally because of that trick, I would just stay first. But I was definitely, when Eileen came down, I was like, that's gonna be tight.
But I heard her. The first thing she said was, Mathilde, you killed it. You are my inspiration. That was the first thing she said. She didn't even look at the score. She just ran to you. That's a beautiful thing.
Yeah, oh yeah, that was really nice. And she was also like, we were waiting for her score and then like laughing. We're like, yeah, we both got a gold and another medal, like one silver, one bronze. And we were like stoked that we both got like, a piece of the gold, and that was really fun. And it was a good time, and I was really stoked for her as well too. Just her mental game is just insane.
Because most people would think, wait a minute, she just got silver behind you because of 0.33. Most people would be frustrated. Why is it that you guys, not just you and Eileen, but all of the women have this incredible bond and this, I don't know, will to want to see each other succeed?
It's really, I don't know, it's just like the mindset of everyone, just it's always been like that, and I hope that it just stays like that and we can just be happy for the others. I don't know, in the end, like, she already, or like, if we talk about Eileen, like, she already had a gold, she for sure had a silver, like, it was just like, I just feel like at a certain level, at least in our sport, we're just like really happy to have something, so we can really enjoy that. And I think that's, yeah, I don't know, it's hard to explain, it's just like, it's pretty organic and everyone's just happy, so.
It's beautiful. It's honestly so beautiful to watch. And the world have just been seeing these pictures and these moments and just kind of, everyone is so behind you and they just love seeing it. So thank you.
Thank you.
No, well, I mean, it's very clear that you are so adored and so respected by your competitors, by the people that you go toe to toe with. So thank you for bringing that. Thank you for being you.
Thank you.
And guys at home, thank you so much for joining us. The one and only Mathilde Gremaud.
Hello there and welcome to the Ski Cross. Racing for gold here. Rydzik, fastest out in red. Oh, and someone's gone down in green. Drury, as well as Sergei Rydzik. Lehmann and Bischofberger now racing. Gold goes to Brady Lehmann.